Hi, in today's video, we'll create a set of rules that will help us to get the most runway from our ad creatives by duplicating them before pausing them forever. Duplicating an ad will trigger a whole new learning phase, and sometimes it just takes a little luck to get an ad moving. So our goal is to create a set of rules which will duplicate an underperforming ad. Then if the copy of this ad doesn't perform well again, we'll duplicate it for the second time, and if it won't help, we'll finally pause it. To start, let's duplicate the pause rule we just made in the previous video about pause rules. We'll change the name to a more appropriate one. And we can keep the same filter selection, which is set to all active ads. For the action, we'll change it to duplicate. In the action settings, we'll choose to pause the original ad. Set the frequency to once in a lifetime and append to the duplicate ad's name -copy1. This all means when this rule fires, it will pause the ad, duplicate it, and add the text -copy1 to the end of the ad name. For the conditions, we can keep this just as they are. So now our rule says, we'll duplicate ads with ROAS of less than 1 and if purchases are greater than or equal to 1 during today and yesterday, or if purchases are less than 1 and we've spent more than or equal to $30 during today and yesterday. This rule also pauses the original ad it duplicated and adds the text -copy1 to the end of the ad name. We can keep the rest of the settings the same and click Set Live or save it as a draft. Now let's make one more duplication rule. So we're duplicating an ad 2 times before we pause it forever. Let's duplicate this rule and change its name to Duplication 2. Then we'll add a selection filter to only include ads that contain -copy1 in the ad name. With this filter, this automated rule will only duplicate an ad that has been duplicated exactly 1 time. The last thing to do here is to update the rule's action settings and append comma 2 to the duplicate ad text name. When we appended comma 2 here, our newly duplicated ads will now have -copy1, comma 2 at the end of the ad name. Everything else can again stay the same. Because we're using the same conditions, what happens to our pause rule? Right now, they'll conflict because they are being applied to the same items and have the same conditions. We'll go back and edit our pause rule selection filters to only include ads that have -copy1, comma 2 in the ad text name. This means it will only pause ads that have been duplicated twice before pausing forever. Great. We also need to go back to our first duplication rule and edit the selection filters in what the rule applies to. We need to add a filter so it only applies to ads that have never been duplicated yet, because this is our first duplication rule. To do that, we'll add a filter for ad name doesn't contain -copy. Okay, let's save it. While that might seem a little confusing, we now have a wonderful automated system to get the most life from every ad. Once an ad goes live, and if it ever underperforms, our first rule will duplicate it to give it a second chance with learning phase, and we'll add to ad's name the tag -copy1. If it underperforms again, our second rule will duplicate it a second time, and change the tag to -copy1, comma 2. And if it underperforms for the third time, we'll pause it for good with our pause rule. And that's all. If you have any doubts about the setup, you can always reach out to us. And we'll see you in the next video.